3. I'm going to run out of room. Hi, my name is Brian. Welcome to another video on derivatives. In this video, we are going to find f prime of a given the function f of x equals 2x plus 1 over x plus 3. So there are two versions of the derivative formula we can use. The first version is f prime of a is going to be the limit as x approaches a of f of x minus f of a all over x minus a. Now that's the first version. The second version is as h goes to 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a all over h. Now both of these will work, but we will find a little, I think it will be a little easier to use the first version instead of the second version. But when you are doing this on your own, try each one out, see which one you like best. But let's go ahead and get started using the first version. Okay, first thing is let's put in all the specifics from our function into our limit. So a is arbitrary, but we can replace f of x with our function. And that will be 2x plus 1, x plus 3. Now f of a is our function just evaluated at a. So that's just going to be 2a plus 1 over a plus 3. And then we're going to divide all of that by x minus a. We do have other videos on techniques on evaluating limits where, you know, with this type of scenario where this is a big complex fraction, where you have fractions, smaller fractions inside a bigger fraction. The way that at least I would deal with them is I want to clear these two because that's what's making this a complex fraction. My trick is then to just multiply top and bottom by the common denominator, because if you ever multiply a fraction by its common denominator, it will remove those denominators. So here, the common denominator, by the way, can always, always be the product of those two denominators. That's what I did here. Now when I multiply this onto this fraction here, you'll see that the x plus 3's will cancel. So what's going to be left is the 2x plus 1 and the a plus 3, because that's not going to cancel with anything, minus. And then when you multiply this on to the second fraction, the 2a plus 1 will stay. The a plus 3's will cancel, but that x plus 3 is going to stay. Now on the bottom, you are going to just leave the x minus a alone because the whole point is to somehow factor an x minus a from the numerator to cancel with this one. Leave these alone for now. Again, x is going to approach a. Okay. It's not as intimidating as it looks because when you start simplifying all of this, it does clean up quite nicely. All right, so let's go ahead and FOIL these out. Distributing that out, we'll get 2xa plus 6x plus a plus 3. So that's foiling out these. And then over here, you're going to have a minus. So you had 2ax. This will give me 6a, but because of the minus sign, I'm going to have to distribute to give me minus 6a. This will be a plus x, which then after distributing the minus, it's minus x. And again, plus 3, but then the minus sign that I'm distributing to give me minus 3. All of that will be over the x minus a, the x plus 3, and the a plus 3. Okay, so let's go ahead and find if any like terms, see if any of these things cancel. In fact, they do. We have the 2ax. Here, the 3's cancel. That's nice. And then we have 6x and then a minus x. So those are like terms. And we also have an a and a minus 6a. So that does simplify to be, well, 6x minus x is 5x. Where'd it go? Plus a and a minus 6a to make minus 5a. And then the bottom is still x minus a, x plus 3, a plus 3. Now, I can factor a 5 out from top, because then once I factor a 5 out, I'll have an x minus a left over to cancel with that. Okay. Go ahead and cancel. So that's the limit, x approaches a. So we'll have the 5, and then on the bottom, x plus 3 and a plus 3. At this point, I can now plug in x equals a, because I'm not going to make the denominator 0 anymore. And that's going to give me 5. We'll have a plus 3 and another a plus 3. So this can be simplified. You can leave it like this, but you can rewrite it as a plus 3 squared. Now the question was to find the derivative f prime of a, which this is. But if you want to rewrite it as f prime of a or f prime of x, it doesn't matter. So I'm going to come up here and do that. So we could say f prime of a is 5 over a plus 3 squared, or you can say f prime of x is 5 over x plus 3 squared. Okay, well, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching. Good luck.